right, next up, let's take a peek at the steering wheel of the vehicle. So a lot of options, a lot of flexibility when it comes down to it. Let's start off on the left-hand side. So this specific one does have the package where we get the adaptive cruise control system. So we can set it if we want to. We can turn the actual system on or off by pressing this button. So as you can see there, it's now on. By moving up and down on this button, that's going to literally let us figure out how close or how far we are away from the vehicle that's in front of us. We've also got our lane keeping system, so we can turn that system on or off. Now, the lane keeping system is an interesting one because what that's going to do is it works a couple different ways. So it's potentially going to nudge us back into our lane, give us a little bit of a steering wheel shake, depending on how we have it set up. We've also got our volume rocker there, so we can adjust our volume if we want to. We can also just do it down there as well. So a lot of flexibility when it comes down to it. And we can press this in order to turn that system off completely again. Boom, and as you can see, system's off. And then we can also turn that lane keeping system off as well. Off to the right-hand side, this is what's gonna actually let us figure out what's going on with this instrument cluster screen. So we're actually gonna go through the basics first. So this is gonna be to answer or hang up a phone call, change between songs or radio stations. We've got our basic menu button, basic back button, up and down, and then our okay button. Now the okay button, if we ever get a message on that screen, we just press the okay button in order to get rid of any messages that we might have. And then we've got our voice command prompt. So voice command prompt is going to let us do things like change songs, radio stations, make phone calls, etc. But let's actually dive into this instrument cluster screen and figure out exactly what's going on. So let's kind of move forward a tiny little bit. All right, so navigating between different screens. So we've got our basic calming screen. We've got fuel economy, our trip counter, which if we ever need to reset, we just hold the OK button in the steering wheel and it's reset us there for us. Moving down, we've got our off-road pages so we can figure out what's going on with our pitch roll, things like that. Down a bit more, we've got our tire pressure, and then we can configure the view as well. So we press OK in order to configure the view. We can add in our turbo boost, oil pressure, and a few other things, but we are limited to what's actually going to show. So we do have a limit as to how many things we'll actually show as we go. Let's throw in our pitch and roll there, and then we go back. And then we've got our pitch and roll as well, so we can see exactly what angle we're on as we go. We can see what's going on with our transfer casings, things like that. And I believe we also added in our turbo boost. There we go. So we've got a little bit of flexibility when it comes down to what's actually showing on that screen. Pressing the back button there, and that's going to bring us back to this screen. So we've got our My View, we've got our Trip Fuel, we've got our Off-Road. So our Off-Road status is kind of neat because we've got a few different things. So we've got our Off-Road status there, we've got our Pitch and Roll page, we've got the Tire Pressure back to our gauges, Turbo Boost, oil pressure, and a few others. So if we go back into our menu there, we go into our off-road, and we've got a series of different options, so we can kind of figure out exactly what's going on there. So this is going to be a, if we go back to our view there, so there we go. So this is going to be a base view of each system. If we jump inside of the actual menu, this is just going to be a different style view instead, and then we just press in order to get to that actual setting. Moving back and then back again, that's going to bring us back to our main screen, and then we can go up and down between some different things. So navigation, we do have the flexibility of being able to navigate, so we can go to our home, previous destinations as well. And that's a neat one because if we go to our previous destinations, so as you can see there,
proceed to the highlighted road.
It's going to navigate for us directly through this instrument cluster screen. So rather than having to navigate off or look off at the side, we can literally just glance down at our cluster and we can see what's going on with the route. We press the button there, the main button, and we can jump back into our navigation. We can cancel the route out as well if we want to. Moving back in, if our phone was connected, that would show up. We've got our audio, so we can change between AM, FM, Sirius XM. If our cell phone was connected, things like that, those all those options would show up. We've got our setting, which we can show the speed in our miles per hour as well. Neutral tow, if we're ever towing the vehicle. And then we've also got our oil life. So if we're changing the oil ourselves, we just press and hold OK in order to bring that back to our default again. And moving back to this main screen, and same thing, we can kind of go up and down. So a little bit of flexibility when it comes down to it. Now the stick on the left-hand side, this is going to be for our windshield wipers, so we can adjust what's going on at that front wiper. We can adjust what's going on with the back wiper. We're going to push in on the tip. So literally, push in on the tip in order to get that front windshield wiper fluid going. And then we're going to rotate down in order to get the back wiper fluid going. So very straightforward there.